¿Qué tal, amigos? Una nueva edición de Auto 060 aquí en Cristina Radio Network, y en este show vamos a pasar de inmediato a una test ride muy especial que hicimos con el nuevo Honda Fit 2015 en San Diego con Carl Pulley, uno de los especialistas de Honda North America.
How are you, Carl?
Very well, thank you, Javier.
Thank you very much for having us here in San Diego. Beautiful weather as always, like perfect weather in
wow.
San Diego.
It's always great to have members of the press come to these things, and yeah, we've got some beautiful roads that we're driving on.
So we're on the new 2015 Honda Fit, and pretty much new in everything, right?
Yep, from the ground up, all new engine, two all new powertrains, new chassis, so yeah, basically everything new.
And also, it's new, the place where it's going to be built for the North American market, because it used to be built in Japan, right?
Indeed, yes. Now it's going to be built in a whole new state-of-the-art facility in Celaya, Mexico. And all of the fits for the U.S., for North America, are going to come from that new factory.
Yeah, because the Fit is a global car, and I guess you were limited to the amount of cars that you could have here for the States.
Yes, I mean, there's other markets where the Fit is a little bit more prominent in the markets, in Europe, in Japan, Southeast Asia, in China. So the challenge that we had was that we could only get a limited supply of Fit. So, I mean, it sold very, very well for the limited supply that we had, but now we're not limited by production any longer.
Yeah. So let's talk about the new things. You said the engine is new.
Yes, it's a new 1.5-litre direct-injected engine. So this is our second direct-injected engine. The first one was on the Accord, which is a 2.4-litre. So many advantages with the high-pressure direct injection, far better atomization, which is much better for combustion efficiency, which provides better power as well as better fuel economy.
And also the transmission, it used to be an automatic and now it's a CVT.
Yeah, so we previously had a 5-speed automatic, and now we have a CVT, which is a new design. We first used it on our Civic, so it's basically the same unit as the Fit, but obviously it's specifically tuned for the Fit, for the slightly smaller engine. Has a higher capacity torque converter, and that's what you feel when you step on the gas, where you have that immediacy of motive motion.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of CVTs, conventional CVTs, you have that kind of rubber band feeling where, you know, the engine seems to be working.
The first generation of those were kind of bad. This one, you don't feel anything.
Exactly, yeah. So we're very, very proud of what the engineers did with the new CVT. And, of course, it allows for that very wide ratio range. It allows the engine to virtually all driving conditions being its optimum rev range, which, again, provides you with great power as well as the wonderful fuel economy.
Are the MPG numbers already out?
Yes, they are, and we have top-of-the-class numbers. We actually have, for the CVT, we have 36 combined MPG.
And that's the only transmission, or there's like another option for the powertrain?
No, there is indeed another transmission for those who like manual stick shift, maybe for those that like to drive a little bit more sportier.
Mm-hmm.
We have a new 6-speed manual transmission.
Okay.
And that has a 5% wider ratio range than the previous 5-speed. And so obviously with the 6-speed, we have closer ratios for each individual gear ratio and a wider ratio range overall. And we did a lot of changes primarily to the stick shift mechanism. It has a shorter throw, it's more precise, and we've reduced the friction from various components.
Yeah.
And so those that like to have control of the transmission, it's a very sporty and precise gear lever to change into those 6 different gears.
Yeah, even though the new transmissions, the CVTs, the automatic transmissions, are much better than any driver, I think.
Yeah, you'd have to be a very good driver to be able to compete with the efficiency of the CVT.
The computers.
Yeah.
So another cool thing about the Fit is that you guys are retrofitting a lot of cool and pretty high-tech features. Like, I love the lane, what's the official name for the camera?
The lane watch.
The lane watch, that thing is amazing.
You know, Honda's one of our main focuses is safety, and if we can assist the driver to be a safer driver, and of course blind spots can pose so many potential issues.
Yeah.
So especially with Lane Watch, you have this nice wide view of the passenger side of the vehicle, so it expands your view and just makes you so much safer. And the one thing about it is that you turn on the turn signal and it'll automatically go. But if you want to have a quick look, even when you're not necessarily turning, you just press the end of the turn signal stalk.
Oh, I see.
And it'll show that view as
without
well.
Without distracting the other people.
Exactly.
And for Miami, it'll be good because nobody uses the turn signal in Miami. So like, that's like cheating the system a little bit. Another cool thing, the rear view camera, is it standard now?
It's,
no fits?
Yeah. This is the Fit is the only model in its class where the rear view camera is a standard feature for all models. So the LX, the EX, the EXL, and then the EXL with Navion. And as you saw, we have the EXL right now. And as you were backing up, you were turning the steering wheel, and the guidelines, they actually move to show you your projected path.
Yeah.
So that's a nice additional feature for the higher trim level.
And also the three different views for the rear view camera, which I don't think I've ever seen in any other cars. And that's pretty useful because in the regular one, you see more or less the lines and you have the direction in some of the features. But in this one, you see three different views.
Indeed, where we have the regular mode, and then we have the wide mode, which is almost 180 degrees. So you can see so much more to the side. And then we have the view downwards, which is kind of like a bird's eye view, especially when you're backing up maybe into a parking spot, maybe in a parking structure where you have a wall there. You can see that wall.
Much more clear than you will see with the other more general view.
And obviously, I mean, it's such a huge safety thing with regards to, you know, especially families that have children, you know, children playing around. That could be an issue. So, you know, we want to try to prevent any sort of potential tragedy from something like that happening. So,
and I think the government is moving forward into like demanding that to be a standard feature. So you're moving ahead of the game.
Absolutely. Yeah. Honda often drives these safety features. We're often the first company to introduce new safety features, and you know, we want it to be available for everyone. Hence, you know, this wonderful Fit, a subcompact vehicle with these, you know, wonderful technologies that assist in driver safety, as well as occupant safety, as well as the people around, other road users, pedestrians, and so forth.
Yeah, and also, I mean, we're driving here almost 60 miles an hour, and pretty quiet cabin. You guys have done a lot of work in that too.
Yes, I mean, and this was from the ground up. I mean, we didn't just mask the sound. The whole body structure is made in a different way. We use a lot more high strength steel, which allows us to have the same rigidity without as much weight, but also more importantly with regards to NVH, noise, vibration and harshness, is that it allows for tighter tolerances, which then provides better sealing. So therefore we kind of prevent those road noises coming into the cabin. Likewise with the new door construction, which is a pressed form, that also provides better sealing. And of course, you know, we use soundproofing materials, which further isolate road noise and engine noise from the cabin.
Yeah. So this segment is very, very competitive. I mean, there's a lot of cars where in which you can pretty much get all this technology for around $20,000, which is the case in for the new Fit, right?
Indeed, yeah. We fully believe in this Fit. We feel it's highly competitive. We have so many more standard features on all of our various trim levels compared to the competitors. So we've got class-leading fuel efficiency, we've got class-leading cargo space, class-leading passenger area, and then we have these host of wonderful technologies, including the rear-view camera, that's standard on all models that we spoke about just a moment ago.
Yeah, and also with the Honda Link system, even though if you don't get Navi, you can get it through an app. That's a pretty cool idea too.
Absolutely, and it's the first manufacturer-developed app, navigation app. So it's the first one by Honda where you can download it onto your phone, and you can plug your smartphone into the system, whether through Bluetooth or the USB connector. And then you can view on the display audio, which is a nice big 7-inch screen, you can view the navigation. So even on the lower trim levels, you still have full navigation capabilities.
And that app, I understand it has a cost, but it's a one-time cost and that's it.
$59.
Not bad for an app integrated into the car.
Absolutely.
And one last thing, you mentioned it briefly there, but I think it's a big part of the story with the Fit. Like the cargo space, I mean, pretty intelligent solutions for example, the seats that fold in very different ways to accommodate all different kind of positions. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yes, we call them the magic seats.
Yeah.
And not only with this new Fit do we have 4.9 cubic feet additional room, but there's so many configurations where the second row seats, we call those the magic seats, they fold completely flat, or they flip up as well, and so you have a nice deep area where you can put something tall, okay, like a house plant or a small dog crate, something of that nature.
Or a big dog, like a Great Dane.
Indeed, yes, and because, especially, you know, some older dogs, they have a hard time kind of getting over a high area. Because the door seals are so low, you can walk that dog in and there's plenty of room for it.
And that idea, I think, of the folding seat upwards, something you brought from the now gone Element, right? Because those cars used to have those seats in the back, right?
Indeed. And we had magic seats, or we do have magic seats in the current Fit as well, but they're further developed for this 2015 model. And another one of the modes is the long mode, where you can actually flip down this passenger seat all the way down and fold flat the magic seats, and you can put a full-size surfboard inside as well.
Or take a nap.
Indeed, that's what we call our refresh mode. And indeed, you can slip your shoes off, stick your feet up, and while you're parked, you can even plug in your iPad and watch a movie on the display audio screen.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much, Carl.
You're very welcome.
It was like a nice drive. A lot of good information about this car. So, thank you very much for your time.
Well, it was a pleasure having you.